It's a very rare situation, you know, when you make a film that you actually don't look back on it with any regret in any frame of it. I'm particularly grateful for these two because it wasn't just that they got the spirit of my parents. They somehow encapsulated them. And Claire spent quite a lot of time with my mother. And they have similarities of character, perhaps. But for Andrew to recreate somebody who has been dead for 23 years was just, to me and to anybody who knew my father, literally extraordinary. About 3 weeks before we started shooting, I was checking my messages, and I got a message from my father using all the words that he used to call me Jay, and I was completely overwhelmed and frankly confused, slow-wittedly. And at the end, the voice said, "How was that?" And of course, it was him. And it was an extraordinary thing. I have one regret, which is really a regret of my mother's. When we showed my mother a clip of the film for the first time, and my mother loves the film, thank God. We showed her a sort of 5-minute clip, and I said, "Don't say anything, just watch it through." It's a bit of, you know, quite a big thing for her. And halfway through, she'd been keeping it in as long as she can. She said, "Oh, I would never have worn that hat," which was the hat she wore in the hospital. So that is my regret, that we allowed her to wear the hat.
And how did she feel about the film, Jonathan?
Well, she absolutely loves the film. I mean, the first time she watched it, she was terrified, which I've never seen before, actually. It's the first time in my life, interestingly, that I've seen her frightened. She said, "I've decided to take the view that this film is not about me at all." So I went, "Okay, that's probably why." And she was sort of in shock, I think, because everything had come back in a most extraordinarily powerful way. She's seen it a couple of times since, and she does absolutely love it. It also is the first thing I've ever done that has validated my own professional life.